you two since then. I do think it's pretty surprising that it's been that small, considering it's a city of 1 million people.
Dublin seems intensely parochial and incestuous, and there's a lot of bitching as well, isn't there?
Crying out loud, Andrew. I mean, if you were in Sheffield or if you were in Liverpool or something, I mean, every band. I mean, talk to Ian McCulloch, right? I mean, the way he used to slag the old guys he played around with, the Pete Wileys and the Julian Copes and all the rest. I mean, they all slag each other. Everybody slags, for crying out loud. You know, it doesn't make any difference in the end. It's all good, clean fun, you know? I mean, it's better than going, "You are all wonderful," pat on the back, you know? It's better than that.
They're coming for you, Dave. Do you feel at a disadvantage being based in Dublin?
Well, it has its advantages and its disadvantages. I think one of the advantages is you have time to grow up. I think it's similar to bands in Liverpool and Manchester and places like that. Where if you're a band in London, you're only out in the rehearsal room, your group on stage, and most A&R men are based in London, so they're going to see it. So if you're not up to scratch at that stage, they're going to put you down. You don't really get a chance to breathe again, you know. Whereas over here, you have a chance to develop. So. It has that advantage. The disadvantage is that the A&R men are based in London, so it's a lot of hassle trying to get them over.
What were the problems I was hearing about with an LP you made for Elektra?
Yeah, that's the last thing we did. We sent demo tapes all over the place, and funny enough, we thought that sort of someone in Britain would pick up on it, but it was an American record company, Elektra, and they sent Andrew Oldham over. He was sort of talent
scout. The Stones manager?
Yeah, well, hippie himself, yeah. And he came over and he said, you know, the band are good. They signed us up, went to London last summer, this time last summer, made the record, it was a good record. Then they said, we don't want to release it. Good luck. So that was that, you know.
No reason?
Well, I think they couldn't pigeonhole us. We're not Duran Duran, any of that career, you know.
You have to make it in Ireland first before you have to start all over again in England.
Well, that's the way. You don't have to make it in Ireland, but I think it helps to get out on stage and try and build up a crowd for the experience of playing live. I mean, some bands have just said, well, forget about it, we go straight to London, but usually they're the bands that get lost.
I'm not winning.
I knew we couldn't come all the way to Ireland without ending up somewhere in a pub. And we're in one now. And if they drink this stuff all day long, I don't know what it is, but it tastes extremely nice. I'm not surprised they make bloody strange records. Rather like these people here, In Tua Nua. Leslie has the distinction of having sung Leopard Skin Pillbox Hat on stage with Bob Dylan without knowing the words. Listen, is it a disadvantage, do you think, coming from Ireland, being in a band?
Not at all, why should it be? There is a scene here in Ireland where, like, there's loads of bands, there's no venues for them to play, but, like, there's loads of bands happening, there's rehearsal rooms, there's everything there for them except the venues. So, I mean, it's very, very easy for people to come and see them, i.e. A&R people, because it's not that far away. I mean, Ireland is, like, what, 50 minutes from London by a plane.
People have been telling me there are more bands in Ireland now than there have ever been. How come none of them seem to be breaking out and we're hearing of them in London? Well, none since you too, really.
I think there's going to be an explosion for them. I mean, there's so many, and people say that there's no scene, but I think there is. If you just go down to a place where we're practicing at the moment, Temple Lane Studios, and there's at least, I mean, 8 or 9 bands there practicing a day. The place is alive with music.
In Tua Nua with the old Jefferson Airplane song, Somebody to Love.